Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Are you seeing crepey skin? A lot of times it's the elbows, the knees, the décolleté, the abdomen, of course the neck and the face we talk about quite a bit. Today, I'm gonna go through six very different solutions, some things you can do at home and of course in the clinic when you wanna get more aggressive treatments or if your at-home treatments just aren't giving you the oomph that you need. It's very important to understand why it's occurring and if it's generalized, of course, replacing collagen in one of the ways I'm going to talk about today is really important. And think about globally and holistically treating the whole body. And we're going to cover some of those as well. So if you like these videos, smash the like button. It helps me bring more of these videos to you. I'm trying to give you the best, most cost-effective treatments, bang for your dollar to save you time, money, and energy. Let's hit the first one. Now, if you're starting to see global collagen loss, one of the easiest ways to globally improve it is to improve your collagen to help the connective tissue and have healthy skin, hair, and nails. And eating your way to it is one of the best. Vitamins A, C, D, E, fish oil, omega-3s, all very important. A lot of people want to take their supplements. It gives them something to do. If one's not working, they can order the next best one. To be frank, the best way to get it is through diet. And it takes a little more time getting your food, preparing your food, and also paying for your food. But think about the money you save on the other end from not having to come into the clinic, get treatments, and all the time that's involved. It really does make a big difference. I lump exercise in there too. Now, the aforementioned are proven, so is exercise. Exercise is proven to help get better skin, to tighten it, to build collagen, along with, of course, sleep. We can put that in there too. But they work by making the body better holistically. And remember, exercise does a lot of things other than change the sugars in the body, help with insulin resistance and avoid that. And as well, increasing circulation and blood flow, of course, brings all that great nutrition to the largest organ in your body, which is, of course, your skin. Number two, everyone loves topicals. It's easy to do and people can try many different types to see what works for them, but after getting out of a damp environment like a shower, of course, applying a nice moisturizer, it can have antioxidants, but also think about two ingredients I think really help, and that is pure hyaluronic acid, and you can also use retinol or retinoic acid, the prescription grade, if the body can take it. And that's just about dosing. You don't want to overdo it. That's what you want to look for in a moisturizer, something with a little more oomph or an active, because if you're seeing crepey skin, you're already lost a lot of collagen. Now we're on to devices. And I did a video on my top treatment for 2021, and it was a device, it was RF microneedling. So I'll revisit that, and you can look up here, you can click, and you can watch that video. It's a very important one because RF microneedling can treat the whole face. You can target fat. A lot of people had questions on that when I did it. I don't want my fat gone. Remember, these devices are all about, if you have a good device, so prescription grade, a medical grade device with enough power, it's about the person making the settings, looking, assessing the face. You can reduce fat in areas you want it gone, and trust me, many people, submentum, edge of the mouth, they want fat gone, but you don't have to. You can maintain skin by changing the depth, the duration of the heat, the pulse duration, and the amount of heat used. So finding a good person to perform the procedure is absolutely key to a great result, but it can also be used on the body. So for areas you see crepey skin, the settings of course will be much different based on the dermal thickness and the amount of fat in the area that you're treating. But that's my number three treatment. Number four, a pseudo injectable. Some people call PDO threads injectables. PDO threads, polydioxinone, it's a thread that goes in. The key to getting a result is the amount of threads, the correct brand. So the type of threads are going to vary, and how old they are, the thickness, the gauge of the thread, But what a lot of people miss is depth. If you're trying to get crepey skin with a thread, you can't be deep. Certainly, of course, you can't be in the muscle. You don't want to be intradermal, but you want to be just below the skin, subdermal, but not too deep if there is fat, because you just won't get a result. Doesn't matter how many you put in. If you don't have the right thread, the right person putting it in, you're not going to get the result. But they are amazing, and the nice thing is they can be put anywhere the skin is, essentially, as long as anatomically there's not anything dangerous close by, you can treat many areas of the body with PDO threads. Make sure to watch my video on PDO threads. I have many and a whole playlist I'll share in the description below. Number five, while it's an injectable, it's all natural. And I know many of you here like to have all natural solutions, maybe before going up to synthetic things like fillers or Sculptra or different things, but it is injectable and it is your own body's blood product, and it's PRF or platelet-rich fibrin. Platelet-rich fibrin, it's very unique to make. Again, I'll put the playlist for you to watch actually at the end of this video. I think it's an important one, also in the description below. It's not PRP, but it does use your blood. You spin it down in a very specific manner so that you get platelets, white cells, and you form a fibrin clot to slowly release growth factors. So think about the best skincare you've ever had, all natural, dripping in underneath in the skin area for about a week, growth factors and healing factors to help thicken the dermis and give you better, beautiful, glowing skin. Of course, I use it in the eyes for plasma eyes, the face for plasma sculpt, plasma lip, hair growth, plasma brow. The possibilities are endless because it's your own body healing, so to speak, itself. Number six, and finally, is injectable biostimulators. Now, I did a whole video, and I'll put a link up here, that's PDO, liquid PDO, because I said PDO threads, it also comes in many countries as a liquid. But the king of collagen stimulators is Sculptra, PLLA, used since the 90s, used in the body for dozens and dozens of years, but in terms of aesthetically to produce volume, to show that it does, in fact, increase the dermal thickness, it's studied and proven, is PLLA, and in this country, Sculptra, many countries around the world. Some countries have other forms of PLLA, but PLLA, poly-L lactic acid, can be injected underneath the skin. It was used interdermally. That can have some problems. If you know, again, where to put it, putting it at the right level, in the correct concentration, it can either tighten the skin or, as we know in the face, produce volume where we want it to. So keep in mind, all these procedures, of course, they're user dependent, just like your skincare. Depends how you use it, depends on the result you get. So subscribe, like the videos, stay tuned here. Gonna help you keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.